Hello, everyone, and welcome to this little YouTube video about a topic that is something you might have heard about. It's composable frontends and answers questions like, how do I use Shopware without using Shopware and I still get a storefront? And today I'm here with an expert. Composable frontends is something that you can use as a developer to create a storefront while interacting with an e-commerce platform, in this case Shopware, solely via the API. Now, why is this a good idea? It sounds just like an API client. This is something that we will answer in this episode. And how does it work on a technical level, of course? So what parts is it composed of? How you can use it? And the most important thing, how you can benefit from it. There is someone with me today. It's an expert on the topic. It is Björn Meyer. Hi, Björn.
Hi, Niklas.
So first of all, why are you here? Who are you? What do you do at Shopware? Oh, yeah, you are a Shopware employee, of course.
Yeah, I'm engineering lead at Shopware and working on composable frontends and also on the team storefront.
So you're doing all storefront stuff except for administration.
Yes, right.
Great. Now, when you say engineering lead, you are like a supervisor or what? How do you imagine your day-to-day job?
Yeah, developing, helping and other developers. Working with the team, I would say. Most of the part is hands-on. And yeah, some part is management, but it's not that much.
So you are a programmer. A developer, yes. a software engineer.
I try to be.
Great. Okay, so my first question, of course, is, and I think everybody has this question who did not yet hear about composable frontends, what's behind the name? What is composable frontends?
Yeah, it sounds a bit fancy, but in technical detail, it's a Next and Vue application. And is connected with Shopware, yeah, for sure.
Okay. Now, when you say it's a Next and Vue.js application, somewhere in my brain, another abbreviation comes up. It's PWA. Is it a new Shopware PWA? Because you mean it's a JavaScript application for,
you know? No, it's an evolution, I would say. I mean, in my previous job, we already built a lot of PWAs, but with Next 3 and Vue 3, a lot of the pain has gone away, like server-side rendering is much easier. So I would say composable frontends is the evolution of what was not so good in PWA.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, some people out there might not know what a PWA is. Can you say quickly what it is in general?
It's it's nice because a progressive web application was pronounced by Google. They pushed the topic a lot, but in general, a PHP website could add features. So it's like a rule set, I would say, you can follow and you can add. Yeah, basically, you just need a manifest JSON to have a PWA. But yeah, there are more principles you should follow for your website to have a really like offline is a most hot feature people know about, but it's not so easy to integrate in a real world example. So, yeah, there are rules, but PWA it was a trend, a hot topic, I would say. But, yeah, it's not that hot anymore.
So, do I remember correctly that the idea behind it was that you have any website and you enrich it with features that have the effect you can install it on your phone and it behaves like an app?
Yes, right.
Okay, so and this is something that is not part of composable frontends.
You can,
although you could do it.
You could do it. Yeah, you could add it if you wanted, but we have it not in our demo store, for example.
Okay, so it's something different, and the idea came from PWA. So the whole disconnecting front and storefront and the Shopware store itself, that's the idea that we kept.
I mean, the most benefit of composable frontends is that you only rely on the store API of Shopware. Mm-hmm. So basically, you are headless, and mm-hmm. if you update your Shopware environment and have some plugins and stuff like that, and you don't have to face with issues in Twig and in plugin compatibility and stuff like that. So the big benefit is just relying on this API,
I would say. So API, only API first, basically. Okay, but before we get into technical details, who is the target group for composable frontends? Is it agencies? Is it freelancers? Who is it?
Yeah, that's a good point, because composable frontend sounds like we're aiming for big customers, like you can compose the search and do whatever. But I would say, like, what I see in the real world examples is that also small customers have a really take on this, because I would say we're aiming with composable frontends for another developer group, like JavaScript developer or maybe also React Vue developer, so more frontend focus. And so I would say it's not only for big customers, because most of the real life projects I was seeing, they have a time to market like 3 months and you are ready to go. So that was really, really nice.
So it's basically for anyone who wants to have quick results and very custom storefront.
Yes, okay. That's right.
Because, I mean, it's always faster to just install Shopware and use your other project, the storefront, as it is. But if you're going the custom route, then you're faster with composable frontends. Is that right?
Yeah, I mean, the normal storefront you get out of the box, you have a lot of compatibility with plugins, so you can use every plugin from the market and hope it will work. And with composable frontends, yeah, you have to install it separately, so you need to set it up, but that's a 5-minute job. And you can basically say you can start with our demo store, like copy-paste it and make whatever you want, or you start with so we have different templates where you can start. Like also we have an Astro template, if you like Astro.
Okay. One moment. maybe let me paint the picture. Now, as far as I understand the project, the baseline for everything is it's a Node.js based API client. So you need some Node.js project, and there you can pull in the API client. And then you have types, helpers, composable, Nuxt module, and CMS base. And these are all parts that you can use, and they build on each other. And the more you use, the more opinionated it gets. You can also clone, you'd call it demo store, but it's more like a pre-created storefront for your shop. So it's not with demo data and stuff. You can just clone it and you have a storefront and go from there. And if you only use the API client, you have a lot of work ahead, but you can also do whatever you want. Just use the API for it. And the deeper you go down the path in the direction of a full ready-made storefront, the more opinionated it gets and the more, full stop. Is that correct?
I mean, we suggest to start on a blank theme, for example, because then the developer team that will provide or will work on the project knows exactly how everything is working. But in real life, I would say most of the project just start with our demo store and removing components they don't want to have, or adding new components, overriding composables. So it depends. So I guess, most of the people out there in real life copy the demo store and then work from that. But to have a real understanding, and you have the freedom to do whatever you want. You can also start with blank. You can, and just use the package you want to have. Like we have a package for CMS. If you want to use our CMS, or we have a two package for API client you can use. So it's, I would say Composable Frontends is a tool set we provide to you to kickstart the project, to help you going fast with a custom storefront. Yeah.
Okay, great. Will this be translated into other languages as well, or is JavaScript the only one that we are planning?
Yeah, at the moment, I guess focus is on JavaScript, yes, for sure. Mm-hmm. So we have also a proof of concept with React and Next.js that is, very new. So I guess, mostly the focus for now is JavaScript, yeah.
Okay, so if we happen to get a strong Go community inside our community, then they would have to do it on their own. But hey, that's okay. So what are the future plans for this project, Composable Frontends, and what must happen for it to survive?
For sure, the community, we need more projects. The community needs to get involved a lot. And I would also say Composable Frontends is at Shopware the first product that is completely working on GitHub. So you can create issues, can participate in discussions on GitHub, and we will also work on that. So you see the project progress. So that's really cool to work open source on that project. And basically, I guess we need more integrations like payments and so on to survive. So we have some, but we need just more to kickstart it, because most of the time, people saying, okay, I cannot go with that or that because this is missing or something is missing.
By developing open source, you mean that we are developing in the open, because usually we have an internal Git system that we commit to first and this gets mirrored outside, just for clarification. Open source as well, not only Composable Frontends.
That's right, yeah.
It's both under the MIT license, as far as I'm aware. Okay, now, frontends.shopware.com is the entry point for everyone. And from there, you can go to GitHub. You get a lot of information. Okay, Björn, thank you so much for giving us all this information. Now, for everyone else, there is a Boost Day coming up. The Boost Day is an event for you out there where you can come to a virtual place in the internets. And there you gather together with other developers from the community, with Shopware employees. There are talks and stuff like that. And the next Boost Day takes place on the 14th of September, 2023. Now, if you watch this on a later date, there will be another one. The link to the Boost Day is in the description, or up here somewhere around the video, there is a link to the Boost Day website, and there you can register. Now, I will be happy to see you there. And if you do not make it to the Boost Day, at least try out the project, because Composable Frontends, as you heard from Björn, is a cool thing. Thanks for watching.